Hi guys, my name is Diana, and I'm a nail artist located in Orange County. And today, I'll be showing you how to create an at-home gel mani. Some of the nail supplies that you need is nail polish remover, alcohol, cuticle remover, basin top coat, cuticle oil, your favorite gel color. And the tools that you need, nail file, nail buffer, cuticle nipper, cuticle pusher, nail brush, lint-free wipes, Q-tips, a cleanup brush, and of course, a gel machine. I have so much stuff. Let's get started on the at-home gel manicure. First, grab your nail polish remover. This is from OPI. This is one of my favorite because it doesn't like dry out your skin. Grab a lint-free wipe, kind of soak some onto the lint-free wipe and wipe off leftover nail polish. And it also gets rid of all the dirt and oil and debris off your nails too. We're gonna use this file. This is from BioStevie Gel. It's 180 to 100 grit. And the shape that I'm doing for my nails are almond shape, so I'm gonna try and achieve that look by filing it from one side to the other and then kind of go towards the center just to round it off a little bit. Notice that I'm doing it one direction and not like a seesaw, like side to side. And after, I'm gonna grab my Q-tip, kind of dip it with the cuticle remover, and then kind of apply it around the cuticle areas for each of your nails. And let it soak for a little bit, and then after, grab your metal cuticle pusher and kind of gently push around your cuticles, like push it upwards just to get rid of all the dead skin, and then wipe off all the dead skin. If you see some of the remaining skin that are sticking out, like your cuticles that are sticking out, get your cuticle nippers and just nip off the parts that are sticking out just to give your nails like a cleaner look. Another tip that I like to use is the end of the cuticle pusher. I like to use that just to go in between my cuticles and the sidewalls of my nails just to get rid of all like the leftover skin that gets stuck in there. And after that, I'm gonna grab alcohol. You can use any alcohol that you have at home and wipe the surface of each nail just to clean it up a little bit. So you're just gonna use the buffer and then buff the surface of each nail. A quick tip is use the corner of the buffer, buff in between the cuticle just to remove all the dirt and oil that's left over, just to give your nail like a clean surface. So when you paint the base coat, it won't start shrinking or anything. Then grab your nail brush just to remove all the debris and dry skin that you just pushed from the cuticle. After you finish, grab the BioStevie Gel Stronger Base One Coat, base coat. I'm gonna paint one coat. After you finish painting the base coat on all of your fingers, you can place it into the gel machine. This one is the one that I'm using from BioStevie Gel, and it's great to use at home because it's small, also lightweight too. So it's very easy to carry and all that. It lights up for 60 seconds, and then once it's finished, you take it out and then apply your favorite gel color. So the gel color that I'm using is called Daydreamer. It's important to paint your nails a thin coat because if you do paint your nails a thick coat, then you might experience some rippling effect when you take it out of the gel machine. It's gonna look a little bit sheer, but you could always build it up with the second coat. And if you do see some of the gel that gets on your skin, make sure to grab the cleanup brush and clean around your nail just to give it a flawless look. So once you finish painting, place your hand into the machine, wait until it's finished curing. After you finish curing, apply the second coat to each of your nail.
To prevent the gel from chipping, make sure to cap the free edge of your nail.
Wait for it to cure. Apply your favorite top coat. My favorite gel top coat is from BioStevie Gel. I'm using the non-white top coat. What's cool about this non-white top coat is that it doesn't create any inhibition layer, which is like that sticky layer that you feel after you take it out on the gel machine. So it saves that extra step for you from wiping the extra tacky layer. Once you finish applying the top coat and you take it out of the gel machine, so what I like to do is grab this cuticle oil. This is from Essie, and you can find this at Target or Walmart, and it smells really good too. Brush it on to each of my cuticle area. Rub all the cuticle oil around the skin and around the nail even underneath it too, just so you don't get no crusty nails. And there you have it, an easy step-by-step gel manicure at home. And if you guys are interested in checking out my work, you guys can follow me on Instagram at RiceKittyNails. Thank you so much, guys, for watching, and hope you guys stay safe out there.